1776. That year had nothing to do with me. Now, some people celebrate when my ancestors didn't come over here on a business trip or on vacation, waving from the deck of the ship, drinking champagne on 17. There were the welcome committees and homeowners associations to help us get acclimated to the neighborhood. No one dropping off a pie, off a couple of sugar, no one saying if you need to borrow some money, just ask. It's all good. There were no classes to help translate the language. There were no direction signs written in our native tongue. Just a shotgun who tried to run in those trees. Those trees, they served as a horrible reminder from which we were home. 1776? For some of us, that's not where it all began. To be stripped of everything and be told for taxation and portion that only you own the 3/5 of a man. Denied the opportunity to learn, beaten if caught trying to write or read. What if Dred Scott said no rights in which a white man was bound to respect? That was their creed. I mean, 1776 is started long before that for some of us. Long before having to guess how many jelly beans in the bar, jar, bubbles in the bar, so not being able to sit in front of a bus. It started long before not being able to register and vote. It started in 1619. Simply put, stolen and put on a boat. We were stacked like corns on that ship, given minimum to eat. No clothing. Can you imagine that horrific ride over? I'm sure our ancestors who survived got very little, if any, sleep. You see, we were taken from our native land. Our families were destroyed. Babies separated from their parents in 1619. Wait, was it 2019? 400 years later, don't you ignore them. Don't ignore babies being put in cages, families being destroyed by today's masks or pay for health care or a livable wage. Okay, I digress. 1619, our ancestors were strong and they were brave. Some so brave they jumped from the ship knowing they couldn't swim, but they knew death was better than being a slave. And in spite of it all, our ancestors continued to thrive. In spite of being created by laws like the Emancipation Proclamation, 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendment, and the Voting Rights Act in 1965. In spite of being Brown versus the Board of Education, our ancestors never lost their faith or their determination. So they built schools and colleges, became scientists, doctors, attorneys, and for us to be where we are today, we should all stand and applaud. But the real reason our ancestors survived, because they knew their God was God. You see, if it wasn't for 1619, America would be a fraction of what it is today. We toured the land, handled the cattle, only to be treated like prey. Our great-great-great-great-grandmothers was raped and nursed in the middle of the night, and the next one she died is if nothing had even happened to her preparing breakfast for master, his kids, and his wife. I mean, if you gonna tell it, then please tell the whole story. Not just bombs bursting in there, we put our hands on our heart and salute old glory.
Say it.
Talk about how we fought on front lines and died for this country trying to defend. And if we only knew we'll return to this country even as veterans, after the war, our blackness was still considered a sin. I mean, we're going to talk about the good, the bad, the ugly of American history. How you stole a whole country and a people. And 400 years later, we're still fighting to be free. So what do we help elect President Obama for? What do you go out, that's not even a drop of cold water in a hot bucket. I mean, what about Emmett Till, Black Wall Street, the bombing of the four little girls, and you think we should just throw our hands up and say, bomb it? I know you said it's been 400 years, we should move on, let it go, why don't we just forget it? But you want us to remember the day of presidency 9-11, yeah, I said it before I take it back, I add more to it. You create laws and legislation, but you're consistently inconsistent because you turn around and break your own rules. But we're putting you on notice, we're coming to get what is right for the hours and the interests. And it's more than 48 years. Thank you.